There are two ways to access your site, through select a site or just to start your integrated site test. So if you already have everything ready to go, hitting option 2 will just walk you through picking your site and takes you straight to the integrated site test. If you wish to select your site for another reason, then we'll go with option 1, select site. We'll go ahead and create a new site, which is option F2. You also have the options to edit a site or delete a site or select a site. You can only delete one if there is no test data stored with it. When you're selecting your site ID, it needs to be something specific and unique to that area. A site is the meter plus all the instrumentation transformers that are fed into that particular meter. That is a site. If you're at a facility that has multiple meters, you have multiple sites. You don't want to use anything like the meter ID or the meter number because meters can be changed. A good thing is location ID, transformer number, something that's not going to change will be changed out. First option, like I said, is your site ID. So what we're going to do for this one is we're just going to call it demo. If you have a USB keyboard, you can speed this up by doing that. Meter form, we're going to go to is our next field. You can either scroll down each one individually or simply select, in this case, 9, which is what we want to do, and select it. And be careful when doing this because when scrolling down, you're also updating these backwards fields of service and service type, so it takes a second to process and you may overshoot your site. We're going to leave this as a 4-wire Y, 3-phase 4-wire Y, 3V, 3C, transformer rated. And then test setup, we're going to need to create a test for this with our test editor, option F4. Now that we're in here, we have new setup, option F2. And we're going to call it what we're doing the test. So we are in a 9S, the 4-wire Y, and we're going to do a customer load test. And a CT. Burden. Measurement. And ratio. By selecting the name this way, anytime I'm doing a Form 9S meter, it's a 4-wire Y, I just have to select this test menu. I don't have to go in and recreate it. We'll be doing a customer load. We'll be doing it in watt hours. If we want to do a demand test, we would check that box. If not, we'll be doing a test time, and I'll do 120 seconds and 5 revolutions. If it is a lightly loaded system, the longest you'll stand there will be 2 minutes. If not, 5 pulses will be pretty quick. The two fields are mutually exclusive. Whichever it reaches first is the one it closes on. We're not going to do a register test. We are going to do a CT ratio test, a CT burden measure. We're not going to do any PT testing. So we're going to save option F6. And then we're going to select that one. And then we'll go over here and put in our case of T or case of H. They're typically the same, but sometimes they are not, so be careful about that. At this point, this is all the information needed to do a test. If you wish, you can fill out the rest of the screen at the bottom, the customer account information, etc. Or you can go option F3, next page, and you can select a meter. If the meter is not present, Then you can go down to option F4, meter editor, and build a meter. And that's also covered under the software training videos. You can put in a serial number, meter number, etc. Gives you the same options with your AMRs. Next page, CTs and PTs, allows you to put in any information for those. However, if you do not have the exact information from the nameplate, leave it blank. It'll test it and calculate it that way. If you put in the incorrect information trying to get the correct ratio, you could cause a test failure. Instructions and warnings, if you have any of those. And then these custom fields, where if we were to change them instead of something user 1 to locator ID or GPS coordinates, it would say it's a user 1, it would be GPS coordinates, or whatever we picked. And two pages of those. It takes us back to the main page. Now we can either option F6, save and exit, or F5, save and select. So we're going to do F5, save and select. This is a new feature that came out with the new firmware for the 3 series. It lets you pick it when you're done and take you to the preparing to do your test screens. You can enter in your technician name, comments, continue. And now we are back at your main menu. However, this time selected site is demo up in the upper right hand corner, and we now have all of our testing options available.